What's up, Willow? I'm Tyren.
I'm Julian.
And this is The Friday Show.
On today's episode, in honor of Thanksgiving, we're going to be cooking a turkey.
Delectable.
Do you even know how to cook a turkey?
Of course I know how to cook a turkey, dude.
I don't believe you.
You better find out.
All right.
We're back with an unprepared, finna be prepared turkey. And the first step you want to do always in preparing a turkey is to prepare the turkey.
Ooh.
Or get somebody else to do it for you. So I'm going to hand it to Chef Pasquinelli.
Thank you. So after we wash our hands, you know, make sure we're all clean and stuff, we gotta take the package, the wrapping, whatever you want to call it off. As we can see, the innards are included. So,
bro, you ever think about, like, the Roman Empire?
I mean, I don't really think about the Roman Empire, but, like, maybe some other people do.
Maybe out there.
Hi, guys. It's Avah, and today's segment is going to be, how often do you think about the Roman Empire? Where we'll be asking teachers and students how often they think about the Roman Empire. Let's get started. Hello, my name is Avah. What is your name?
My name is David Schneider.
Nice to meet you. So I have a question. How often do you think about the Roman Empire?
3 times a day?
That is a really good question. I would probably say every other day, only because I think about it a lot in social studies class, which I have Mr. Schneider, wonderful teacher, wonderful man. I have him on B-days, so every other day I'd probably say I think about the Roman Empire. Yeah.
Thanks, Nicholas.
You're very welcome.
Live in the shadow of the Roman Empire. Mm-hmm. There's a science fiction author named Philip K. Dick, and at the end of his life, he believed that he was contacted by an extraterrestrial intelligence that he called Valis. And according to him, the Roman Empire never ended.
Rarely.
Okay. And what subject do you teach?
I teach social studies. I teach freshman geography.
All right.
Roman law, Roman culture, Roman symbols. Mm-hmm. These are all symbols, culture, and law that we would recognize today.
I don't know what that is. Buenas tardes.
Buenas tardes.
¿Estás bien?
Estoy muy bien, ¿y tú?
Sí. Muy bien. So, tengo una pregunta. How often do you think about the Roman Empire?
That's a good question. Weekly?
Every day.
At least twice a class.
At least 3 times a day.
When I brush my teeth in the morning.
The Roman Empire expanded so greatly, so you've gone from all the way to Europe. So I think about Mark Anthony and Cleopatra a lot, Caesar. So that kind of happens quite often. Yeah. So weekly, if not more.
Every day, every hour, every second.
Every millisecond.
More. She's just trying to beat me. The thoughts are brewing.
You know, I think about the Roman Empire a good 7 times a day. What about you? Actually, I don't care. What you doing with that turkey?
You know, I'm preparing the turkey so we could start.
How are you preparing the turkey? You know what I'm saying?
I'm taking the skin off so we could put the
compound.
So
we could do what?
We could put the compound. We could put the compound butter into.
What's compound butter?
Like, it's a butter. You get butter and you put other stuff.
What
in
type
it.
Of stuff do you put in the compound
sage
butter?
Sage and thyme.
That's it.
I mean, you don't.
That's it.
You put other
sage and thyme. That's like nothing, dude.
You
need
other
more
stuff.
Seasoning than that.
What other seasonings, man?
Like all of them.
Okay, can we roll to the next clip? I'm done.
Oh, sucks for him. We don't have another clip. So, you know, I'm going to go to mixing these seasonings and whatever compound butter is.
I'm doing all the work over here.
I don't care. I'm going to go do that.
You know, I'm still mixing up the butter. It's a little more, you know, compatible.
Yeah, you know, it's a little less, you know, in seasoning. Like my family, we would use like paprika or some Tony's, you know. Some rosemary. You don't got none of that.
All right, man. You know what? If our families had a cook-off, I bet we beat you, man.
Stop it. You would not beat me.
You want to make a bet?
I would make a bet.
You will make a bet?
I want to make a bet.
You know what? Let's check out those other family dishes.
Let's check it out.
Let's check them out.
This is the show where three contestants compete for the spirit stick. My name's Kennedy, and this is Willow Chopped. Now let's meet our chefs and judges.
My name is Kai. I'm a 5-star chef from Toronto, and I'm very excited to try people's food today. I'm trying to see who could be in my kitchen.
What's up? My name is Blair. I'm from Gentilly. I'm one of the judges here. Just here to taste food. I was kind of bribed into this, so just kind of here for a ride to art class.
My name is Mel LaBeouf. I'm from Southern Texas. So my dish is my grandpappy's recipe of a real Texas style pie. I think I'm gonna win today because anybody got that Texas flair like me. So I'm really bringing that oomph to the cooking show.
My name is Nathaniel Leon. I started cooking when I was about 7. My mother taught me how to cook. Still learning from her to this day. And I'm here to win the spirit stick. The dish that I made is very sweet pasta. My dish has noodles and lots of sugar. Came from my imagination, my brain. I think I'm gonna win the spirit stick. My dish is amazing.
My name's Nye Chaplin. I'm from Southern Louisiana. And I've been cooking since I was a little tyke, you know? And my grandma, she's always making sweets. So of course I have to make sweets too. I made my famous spicy Rice Krispie Treats, and I'm gonna win the spirit stick because mine tastes the best. My opinion on the judge is that Kai knows good food. Kai knows how to get down. She don't play. Blair, he might know something about a little bit, but Kai's gonna come in clutch for me, I know.
My name is Nathaniel. It's my Alfredo sugar noodles. Eat up.
You said sugar.
Mm-hmm.
Sugar. Like noodles?
Mm-hmm.
Sugar. Why decide to put sugar in noodles?
What was the conscious decision you made to get here?
Imagination.
I can tell you put a lot of imagination into it.
You did. It's like, I like the sauce. Like, the sauce is good. It's just like, why did you feel like sugar was an ingredient you wanted to be the main component?
Sweet is good.
Nah, it's pretty chill, though. I think it's just the sugar. Like, the sugar is just
Thank
really
you.
Making it not the best.
Thank you for your food.
It's like a solid 7.
My name's Anai, and this is my Rice Krispie dish with a little bit of spice on it.
That's actually kind of tough. I'll give this like a solid 7.
It's pretty good. I like the marshmallow texture.
I like the apple jack. Like, the crunch it gives is not like Rice Krispie treats. Like, it's a solid crunch.
I'm gonna need something just to go right over.
Hi y'all, my name's Simone, and today I prepared my grandpappy's original recipe. It's a Texas pie.
Word. It's food.
It's very sweet. I could feel the peas popping in my mouth with the Oreos.
Are those the black beans?
No,
it's peas, goldfish, grape jelly, cinnamon, sugar, and teddy grams.
Your grandpa made this?
Yes, my
grandpappy.
Mm-hmm.
Is he still alive?
Yes, he's
still alive. I rate it 5.5.
I'll give it a 9.
Thank you. Thank you, Chef. Thank you.
We decided the person who won the spirit stick is...
Ah, I told y'all my Southern twang was gonna win! Y'all, I really appreciate it. So, I won, y'all are mad, and I know Simone is salty. She needs to take her Southern salty behind back to Texas because Louisiana on top. And that little kid, I don't know where he came from, but he lost to Big L.
Y'all, this show is rigged. Did y'all see me get a 9 and I still failed? My grandpappy is literally rolling around in his grave right now. Like, why would y'all send y'all's money here?
Okay, it's guys, catch y'all on the next episode of Willow Chopped.
You said your grandpa was alive.
Oh, well, now he's
all right, so it's all buttered up, you know, and now we're gonna go on to the next step, which is the dry brine, you know, put the salt on, make the skin extra crispy, and you know, and then we'll put it in the oven, let it bake.
Dude,
what?
The oven isn't on. Like,
what do you?
It's not.
What do you mean? I turned it on. Look, bro.
That's the light, dude.
Oh, but
we don't even have time to cook the turkey
anymore.
Yeah, I don't even have anything to say, man. All that talk you were doing, and you didn't even you didn't even turn the oven on, man.
See, I said my family could cook, not me. Well, that was the Friday show. Julian.